Hi, everybody. Dan Illman, Mike Beer, kicking off a 20-cent pick five at Woodbine on Saturday. It's really a star-studded card with several graded stakes races. One of them's the Selene. It's a grade three for three-year-old fillies going a mile and a 16th on the Tapita. We have a 4th of July sale going on at DRF.com. 50% off select handicapping products. Learn more at shop.drf.com. Here's the field for the grade three Selene, and it's a pretty evenly matched group, Mike. The number six, Gazala, looks like will scratch. I spoke to Graham Motion earlier this week. He said he didn't ship her up to Canada. Wants to run her in the Christiana at Delaware on Saturday. Katish, 5-2 on the morning line, coming off a big fig.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. It looks sort of well matched on paper on the way in, Dan. That being said, it does kind of feel like that if Katish runs the race on Saturday that she ran last time, she's probably just going to win again.
She likes to be up close to the pace. Let's see where she is on the Timeform US Pace Projector, and they have her right up close along with Join the Dance, number five, who's one of several in here trained by Mark Cassie, stretching out in distance. I would expect Join the Dance to be on the lead. I would expect Katish to be close.
Yeah, I looked at it the same way. I do think Join the Dance is going to the front in this race. That's just sort of been her running style right along. Katish, she's got speed, but she doesn't look like the kind of horse who has to be in front.
And although the number one Absolute Jewel will be stretching out around two turns for the first time, I agree with the pace projector and that she's likely going to come from off of the pace. After this very nice win on the turf going 7/8 of a mile, we'll watch Absolute Jewel's performance. She settled near the back of the pack in this race. She's going to angle out to the outside. She's still a little bit green, but she runs down this field. The buyer is improved, but she's going to have to take another big step up as she switches surfaces, stretches out, and faces winners.
Yeah, there's a lot working against her. She runs fine in here. You see her a little bit late to change leads there, but it's a pretty game finish from off the pace. She finally takes over in the relatively late stages. She winds up winning clear. It's a nice performance. It just feels like she's going to have to take a pretty big step forward to beat this field. And this is a pretty good field she's facing.
Josie Carroll might have a very promising filly in the number two Pioneer's Edge. Two starts, two buyer speed figures of 74, just missed in her first start against winners. Start number two, this race, the Fury going 7/8 of a mile. And as you see, she's kind of over in behind horses turning into the stretch. She's going to get some room. She's going to come with a late run and only be beaten by a head. And her pedigree to me indicates that this extra distance shouldn't pose a problem.
Yeah, I agree with you. She's unlucky not to win this race. She runs really, really well in here. Just, you know, getting caught over behind horses, it just really cost her. Then it took her a little while to get her legs back underneath her there, but she finished really well at the end of that race. Her debut was also a really nice performance. Still very green in that race, but really ran through the stretch.
Mrs. Barbara, the number three, probably lacks the upside of a horse like the two Pioneer's Edge. Heck, she's already run nine times, but she appears to be coming into this race in good form for Cassie. Let's watch her last start, the Willing Angel. It never looked like she got position, and she turns for home with a lot of work to do. She had already been steadied on the turn. She's now going to try to split horses. She's going to get pinched right here. She'll alter course down to the inside, and she actually starts running a little bit too late.
Yeah, another horse who probably was unlucky not to win in this race. The pace just never really developed in front of her. I'm not sure why they weren't more aggressive with this horse early on, but they weren't, and it wound up costing him at the end. The good finish there way too late. Overall, I just like her form, Dan. She was a good two-year-old. I really liked her grade three win at the end of last year, and I think she took a step forward last time.
And that grade three win, the Mazarine, did come around this two-turn distance. So maybe stretching out will help Mrs. Barber get a little bit closer to the pace. I was disappointed that she wasn't involved in the early stages last time out. Efrata, the number four, made a very exciting North American debut for Josie Carroll. That was a 7-furlong race on the Tapita, and she just swept by everybody on the turn and kept right on rolling, wearing her cheek pieces. Now, they ran her on turf last time out. She just didn't really fire that day, but I'm willing to give her an excuse. There was no pace, and she tried to get into it with an outside bid.
Yeah, those things are true. I mean, she ran fine last time, I guess, all things considered. She certainly had a shot to win that race, and I guess ultimately just wasn't quite good enough. But she still ran fine. I really, really liked her return from the layoff, though, over this surface. That was a really impressive win. Now, maybe it was the shorter distance that had everything to do with that, and she's not quite as good stretching back out. I guess that remains to be seen. But I'll tell you something. If she runs as well in this spot as she did two starts back, she can win this race.
I tend to agree. I am a little bit interested to see if she'll end up being a closing sprinter down the road, but the connections overseas wanted to run her long, her last several starts. I think a mile and a 16th well within her scope if she gets the right trip. Join the Dance is up next, and Join the Dance ran third in the Ruling Angel last time out behind Mrs. Barbara, and considering all the trouble Mrs. Barbara had that day, it's hard to argue that Join the Dance ran better.
Yeah, that's how I looked at it too. You know, we'll see. Maybe stretching back out though is a good thing for Join the Dance. She did win, you know, over this distance last year. She does have good speed. And so, you know, maybe she just gets loose on the lead here and becomes really, really dangerous. I definitely preferred other horses in here though.
But I do agree with you that I think getting back out to two turns will help. She now has two sprint preps. And if she gets to the lead and is able to maybe walk the dog a bit, she could last a long way. Gazala the Six expected to run at Delaware Park on Saturday. We'll move to the seven. Super Hoity Toity, who's getting Lasix for the first time for Cassie. This one's making her first start of the year. We haven't seen her since the Mazarine, where she was beaten by Mrs. Barbara. And it just seems like a tough spot off the layoff.
Yeah, I'm worried about that too. I do think there's some upside with this horse though. You know, her maiden win, her first time on this surface last November. I mean, that was a super slow pace that she was sort of stuck in behind. But once she finally got room, she actually won that race pretty easily. I thought she ran fine in the Mazarine last year, Dan. I mean, she wasn't, you know, quite good enough to win that day, but she was really racing on at the end of that race. I think there's a lot of upside here.
Katisha is the morning line favorite. Her last two races with Lasix have resulted in blowout wins over Synthetic, including this performance, going to Smile in a 16th distance. And Jonathan Thomas is such an excellent trainer. I have a feeling he shipped her up here to get a race over the track. I have a feeling the Selene has been the goal all along.
That's probably true. A good way to look at it. Two of her last three races, just really, really impressive performances. I still think she's a little hard to get a read on, Dan, because the maiden win at Gulfstream over that Tapeta surface just feels like she was in a terrible field that day while loose on the lead. Last time, I mean, I don't know, man, she ran a really, really fast race, and she was impressive. I'm not going to sit here and try to knock this horse. I'm just not sure how short a price I'd be willing to take.
Before we get to our top selections, please click the subscribe button on the Daily Racing Form YouTube channel. Saratoga, Del Mar, right around the corner. Get all the latest from DRFTV. Top pick time for the first leg and the 20-cent pick five at Woodbine on Saturday. Mike, you're going with Afrada, hoping she can revert to that good form she showed on Synthetic in her first start in North America. I have to use her. I like that race as well.
Yeah, I'm just going to give her a chance. The more I looked at the race, the more I wanted a price. Not that I'm, you know, super convinced that the favorite on the outside there, Katish, isn't as good as she looks on paper. Maybe she'll just win. I just wanted a better price, and I really liked that race from Afrada.
Mrs. Barbara, we saw the trouble she had last time out, and I have a feeling her uncoupled stablemate Join the Dance might make Katish work, at least in the midpoint of the race, and maybe set things up for a closer like an Afrada or a Mrs. Barbara. And hey, we haven't even talked about Pioneer's Edge, who could easily win this race with slight improvement. It's a good addition of the Grade 3 Selene at Woodbine on Saturday. 4832 for Mike. I'm going to go with Mrs. Barbara. Good luck.